Yes, today we are going to discuss about the spinal cord part 2. That is the internal structure of the spinal cord. The internal structure of the spinal cord is basically divided into two parts. One is the gray matter, another one is the white matter. In this chapter, I am going to cover detailed structure of the gray matter. Myself, Dr. Muralidhar Badigir, Department of Sharirachana, Gramin Ayurvedic Medical College, Therdal. See, if you have taken the cross section of the spinal cord, basically the interior of the spinal cord consists of the two part. One is a gray color H-shaped structure that is called gray matter, and that is surrounded by the white matter. It means gray matter is placed in the center and white matter is placed in the periphery. So spinal cord, if you have taken the cross section, then you will get the two structures. One is a gray matter and another is the white matter. What is this gray matter? What is this white matter? Before going to understand this, first you should know the parts of the neuron. See, the neuron has a cell body and the axon. Cell body and the axon. If the cell bodies are collected in one place, so that collection of the cell body in the CNS is called by the name of gray matter. If the similarly, the collection of the axons, especially the myelinated axons are collected, so that is called by the name of white matter. Wherever I am using the word in the nervous system, gray matter, try to understand it is a collection of the cell body. Wherever I am using the word white matter, try to understand it is a collection of the axons, especially the myelinated axons. In this chapter, I am going to cover a gray matter in detail. See, I took the cross section of the spinal cord here. This is the centrally placed gray matter. It means that the gray matter is centrally placed. It is placed in the center and it is H-shape. So this is a H-shape, or you can say it is a butterfly shape. And this gray matter is nothing but the collection of the cell body of the neuron that is called by the name of gray matter. Here, this is not only collection of the cell body, along with the cell body of the neuron, a little bit neuroglia cells and blood vessels are also present in the gray matter. Next, this gray matter is studied under the two headings. One is the nucleus theory, another one is the laminar theory. So this is already I told, the collection of the cell body is called gray matter. If this gray matter is embedded in the deeper part of the CNS, then it is called nucleus. So nucleus means also it is a collection of the cell body, but in the deeper part. So what is this nucleus theory? So spinal cord, further gray matter of the spinal cord is further divided into subdivisions according to the nucleus. So according to the nucleus, nucleus 1, nucleus 2, nucleus 3, nucleus 4, like this. According to the nucleus, if you are studied, then it is called nucleus theory. It means in the nucleus theory, the specific nucleus are related to the specific function. So this theory is called by the name of nucleus theory. There is another theory instead of this nucleus theory. If the spinal cord gray matter is divided into slice or lamina, then it is called by the name of laminar theory. And this laminas are, total number of the laminas are 10 in number, 6 are present in the posterior gray horn, and 8 and 9 are present in the anterior gray horn, and the 10th one is present around the center, and 7th is present or related to the lateral gray horn. So whatever it may be, so try to understand, spinal cord is studied according to the two theories. One is according to the nucleus, it's called nuclear theory. According to the lamina, that's called laminar theory. And in this video, I am also covering comparison between the nuclear theory and the laminar theory. See, first we are going to discuss the parts of the gray matter. So gray matter, if you taken the gray matter, divide the gray matter into two equal halves. In one side, I am going to explain. See, the posterior gray matter parts, it is a gray matter is H-shape. Then we are going to discuss the parts of the gray matter. So posterior gray horn, this is a posterior gray horn, anterior gray horn, this is anterior gray horn, lateral gray horn, and the right and left gray matter communicating each other in the center, so that is called gray commissure. So one by one we are going to discuss. First we are going to discuss posterior gray horn. It means this is a posterior gray horn. So this posterior gray horn is elongated, and it is also known as dorsal gray horn. And it projects posterior laterally, and it receives the sensory neuron, and first order sensory neuron is going to terminate here. Second order sensory neuron is going to start here. It means it is a collection of cell body of second order neuron. It means posterior gray horn, which is elongated, which is projecting posterior laterally, and which receives the sensory neuron. or sensory nerve. And next, this anterior gray, posterior gray horn further divided into nucleus, that is called nuclear theory. Anterior posterior gray horn further divided into lamina, that is called laminar theory. First, I am going to cover the nuclear theory. The anterior gray horn, posterior gray horn further divided into five different nuclei. The first one is posterior marginal nucleus. Second one is substantia gelatinosa. Third one is nucleus proprius. Fourth one is visceral afferent nucleus. Fifth one is dorsal nucleus of Clarke's. So these are the posterior gray horn further divided into five group of nucleus. It's very easy to remember. First one is posterior marginal nucleus, substantia gelatinosa, nucleus proprius, visceral afferent nucleus, and dorsal nucleus of Clarke. So these are the subdivisions. And come to the point, laminar theory. So this posterior gray horn is further divided into lamina, lamina number 1, lamina 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It means the posterior gray horn is related to the 6 laminas. And next we are going to study the comparison. The first lamina is concerned with the posterior marginal nucleus. Second lamina is related to the substantia gelatinosa. And third, fourth, fifth nucleus are related to the nucleus proprius. And this is a visceral afferent nucleus and dorsal Clarke nucleus. They are also comes under this area only. But mainly third to sixth lamina concerned with the nucleus proprius. The next we are going to discuss the anterior gray horn. See, this is the anterior gray horn. This anterior gray horn is a broad and the short, and it is also known as ventral gray horn, and it projects anterolaterally. It is projecting anterolaterally, and from which the motor nerve is exiting out. It means the cell body of the second order motor neuron are lying here. From the cell body of the second motor order neuron, the neuron axons is coming, and next it continues supplying to the muscles. This anterior gray horn is also studied according to the two theory. One is the nuclear theory, another one is the laminar theory. First, we are going to discuss about the nuclear theory. The anterior gray horn further divided into three group of the nucleus, that is a lateral group of the nucleus, central group of the nucleus, and medial group of the nucleus. So lateral group of the nucleus are further divided into three group, said that is anterolateral or ventrolateral nucleus. Ventrolateral nucleus is related to the arm or the thigh region, and dorsolateral nucleus, so that is related to the forearm and the leg muscles, and retrodorsolateral, it means more posterior, so that is that nucleus is related to the hand and the foot muscles. For example, if retrodorsal nucleus is damaged, in that person you will get the symptoms related to the hand and the foot motor loss. If the ventrolateral nucleus is damaged, then we may get the symptoms in the patient. There is a motor loss in the arm and the thigh region. Next, we are going to discuss about the central group of the nucleus. So the central group of the nucleus is the only one which is related to the phrenic nerve. So you can also known as this is a phrenic nerve nucleus. Next, we are going to discuss the medial group of the nuclei. The medial group of the nuclei further divided into two, anterior medial and posterior medial, or ventromedial and the dorsomedial. This ventromedial and dorsomedial nucleus are related to the muscles of the trunk region. They are supplying to the muscles of the trunk region. If there is any damage to the medial group, then there is a problem related with the trunk muscles. You can see in this picture, this is the anterior gray horn. This anterior gray horn is divided into lateral group of the nucleus, central group of the nucleus, and medial group. The lateral group further divided into three. See, this is a most anteriorly it is present. It is called anterior lateral group. This is called posterior lateral group. This is called more posterior. Then it's called retro posterior lateral group. The centrally there is only one. So, and medial group, the medial group are further divided into two. One is anterior medial, another one is posterior medial group. So this posterior medial and anterior medial group related to the trunk region muscles, and lateral group muscles are related to the upper limb and lower limb muscles, and central group is related to the phrenic nerve nucleus. So this is about the nuclear theory. Come to the point, laminar theory. The anterior grey horn is divided into only two lamina, that is 8th lamina and the 9th lamina. So this is the 8th lamina and the 9th lamina. 8th lamina in comparison with the, I am comparing this anterior grey horn nuclear theory and laminar theory. So this 8th lamina is concerned with medial group of the nucleus, and 9th lamina is concerned with the lateral group and the central group of the nucleus. Next, we are going to discuss about the lateral horn. So this is a lateral horn is the small and projecting laterally. It lies between the posterior horn and the anterior horn, and it is present only in the thoracic and the upper lumbar region, and it's mainly concerned with the sympathetic nervous system. See, the lateral horn, anterior horn and dorsal horn, posterior horn, both are present throughout the length of the spinal cord, but lateral horn is not present throughout the length of the spinal cord. It is only present in the lumbar region and the thoracic region. Why? Because it is concerned with, or from the lateral horn, the nerves are arising. They are related to the sympathetic nervous system. The autonomic nervous system is basically divided into two parts. One is the sympathetic nervous system, another one is the parasympathetic nervous system. So this lateral horn is related to the sympathetic nervous system. So sympathetic nervous system is also known as thoracolumbar outflow, because the nerves for the sympathetic nervous system are arising from thoracic part of the spinal cord and upper lumbar part. Because of that reason, it is called thoracolumbar outflow. The sympathetic nervous system is also known as thoracolumbar outflow, means the sympathetic horn or lateral horn must and should be present in the lumbar and the thoracic part only. So this this lateral horn is also divided into two parts. One is a laminar theory and the other is a nuclear theory. First, we are going to discuss the nuclear theory. So these nucleuses are called by the name of intermediate group. In the lateral horn, the nucleus is present, that is called intermediate group of the nucleus. So this intermediate group of the nucleus is further divided into lateral group and the medial group, that is intermedio lateral group, intermedio medial group. And this lamina these nucleuses are comparing with the laminar theory. The anterolateral grey horn, this is a lateral grey horn. So this lateral grey horn is related with the 7th lamina. It means a 7th lamina is concerned with, the 7th lamina is concerned with the lateral horn. It means 7th lamina means intermedio medial group and intermedio lateral group of the nuclei. Then last point we are going to discuss is gray commissure. The right half of the gray matter and left half of the gray matter, both are communicating each other in the center. So that is called gray commissure. So this gray commissure is further divided into two parts by the help of the central canal. Anterior to the central canal, the right and left gray matter is communicating. This is called anterior gray commissure. And posterior to the central canal, so right and left gray matter communicating each other, so that is called by the name of posterior gray communication or posterior gray commissure. So this anterior gray commissure or posterior gray commissure, or you can say around the central canal, whatever the gray matter is there, so that gray matter is considered as a lamina number 10. So lamina number 10, which includes around the central canal, whatever the gray matter is there, that gray matter is considered as a lamina number 10. Next, last point, in the summary, the gray matter is divided into three parts: posterior gray horn, anterior gray horn, lateral gray horn. The posterior gray horn is concerned with the lamina number 1-6, and this is a laminar theory. According to the nuclear theory, posterior gray horn consists posterior marginal nucleus, substantia gelatinosa, nucleus proprius, visceral afferent nucleus, and dorsal nucleus of Clark. And anterior gray horn, which is concerned with lamina number 8 and the 9th according to the laminar theory. And according to the nuclear theory, the anterior gray horn consists mainly three nucleus: lateral group of the nucleus, central group of the nucleus and medial group of the nucleus. The lateral group of the nucleus further divided into three group: ventrolateral group of the nucleus, dorsolateral group of the nucleus, retrodorsolateral group of the nucleus, and next there will be a central group of the nucleus. There is no further division. And medial group of the nucleus are also divided into two groups: ventromedial and ventrolateral group. And last one is lateral grey horn, which is present only in the thoracic and the lumbar region, upper part of the lumbar region, which is concerned with the lamina number 7th. The lamina number 7th is concerned with the nucleus, that is called intermediate nucleus. So intermediate nucleus are further divided into two groups: intermedial, intermediolateral group. With this, I am completed the detailed structure of the grey matter. Thank you.